Welcome to all, myself Dr. Surbhi Sahni. Today we are going to talk about another topic of biochemistry which you read in first year of dentistry as well as in MBBS, that is introduction to carbohydrates. Again, as the name suggests, carbohydrates. It is made up of three words: carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. It is also known as hydrates of carbon, and the another name is, it is also known as sugars because of two properties. The first property is it is sweet in taste, and second one is it is soluble in water. Carbohydrates are found to be the most abundant natural molecule in nature. So the proper definition which you need to write in your paper is, carbohydrates are the polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketone compounds which are produced on hydrolysis. Let's understand it well with the functions of carbohydrate. As we all know, carbohydrates have a wide range of functions. So its first function is, it is the most abundant dietary source of energy of all the organisms. Second function is, carbohydrate including glycoproteins or glycolipids will participate in the structure of the cell and also perform certain cellular functions like cell adhesion, cell growth, fertilization and so on. Carbohydrates are found to be the precursor of many organic compounds like fats, amino acids and so on. The fourth function is, it acts as a storage form of energy to meet the immediate requirement of the body. Basically, it is stored in the form of glycogen. Now, next is carbohydrates, also known as saccharides. Saccharides basically come from a word, Greek word, that is saccharos, which means sugar. Therefore, carbohydrates has been classified into three types on the basis of the sugar units. It is classified into three types, that is monosaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharide. Basically, again as the name suggests, monosaccharides. Monosaccharides, mono means one. That means it has only one sugar unit and it cannot be further hydrolyzed. Moreover, that's why it is known as simple sugars. Monosaccharides are further classified into two types based on two classification. Two bases are there. The first base is based upon the functional group, monosaccharides has been classified. Second base is number of carbon atom present. On that basis, monosaccharide has been classified. So the first base is on the basis of the functional group, monosaccharides are classified into two types, that is aldoses and ketoses. Again, as the name suggests, when the functional group is aldehyde, it comes under the category of aldoses. When the functional group is ketone group or keto group, then it comes under the category of ketoses. The example of aldoses are glucose and example of ketoses is fructose. The another basis for the classification of the monosaccharide is on the basis of the number of carbon atoms. It is classified into three many types, like three carbon atoms, trioses, four carbon atoms, tetroses, five carbon atoms, pentoses, and so on. The next classification include oligosaccharides. Oligo means few. That means it may contain 2 to 10 sugar units. It can also be liberated on the process of hydrolysis and they are also sweet in nature and soluble in water. That's why monosaccharide and oligosaccharide are considered to be the sugars because of these two categories. and therefore oligosaccharides are further divided into two types, that is disaccharide and trisaccharide. The last part of the classification is polysaccharide. Again, as the name suggests, poly means many. It can be up to the million of the units of sugar, but the main characteristics of polysaccharide is that it is not known as a sugar, it is known as non-sugars because of again two properties. First, it is tasteless. Second, it forms collide when it comes in water, it forms a collide solution. Therefore, polysaccharides are further divided into two types, that is homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. So that's all about the introduction of carbohydrates. What are carbohydrates? Write its definition, its classification, very important, a long question may come in your theory exam. And along with this, the difference between homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides is another question which is very important for your theory exams in first year. So if you like this video, you can drop me the comment section which part you like the most, and you can also press the like button, do subscribe more, share my video, and don't forget to press the bell icon. You can also follow me on Instagram with my name Dr. Surbisani. Thank you for watching.